in this question, it's given that x minus y is equal to 4 and value of xy is 21, and you have to find out the value of x cube minus y cube. Again, in such problems, what should be the approach? If you see linear terms, and in there, here it is xy is equal to 21 is given and x minus y is 4 is given. Now I have to come to, from this expression, we have to lead to this particular expression. How to do that? So if you see, there is an indication, there is a power 3, right? Both are having power 3. That means it is kind of indicating that you could find something with this operation. That means if I raise both the expressions to power 3, I will definitely get some terms in the expansion, which will be x cube minus y cube. So let us see whether that helps. So we have been given x minus y is equal to 4, isn't it? So raising both sides to power 3, we'll get x minus y whole cube is equal to 4 cube. Very good. And now we know x minus y whole cube by our identity knowledge. We know this is nothing but x cube minus 3x square y plus 3xy and xy squared and minus y cube, and this will be 64. 4 cube is 64. Now we have learned one arrangement. If I have to basically find these two, isn't it? So let us see what is it. So x cube minus y cube is what we expect, and rest everything should be transferred on the other side. So it will be 3x square y minus 3xy square. So this goes on the other side, becomes negative. This goes on the other side, becomes positive. So that's what I have done here. Now if you see closely, this is nothing but 64, and there are few terms common in this, guys, isn't it? So I can take 3xy common and it becomes x minus y, isn't it? So what will it become? It is nothing but 64 plus 3 times xy. Xy was given as 21, you see here, and x minus y again I can use it as 4, hence the value should be 64 plus 12 times 21 is 252, isn't it? So hence the value will be nothing but, if you add both of them, you'll get 316. So this should be the answer. X cube minus y cube should be 316. So learning is the indication, we went by our indication, or the field which was coming, as in if there was a cube here, so that in a way they are asking us to cube the binomial. So if you cube the binomial, I will get this term. That's what we did in this question. Again, if you see, there is given that x plus 1 by x is equal to 7. So you have to find the value of x cube plus 1 by x cube. If you see again, it is hinting us to go for a cubing of the binomial. So let's do that. So if I do x plus 1 by x whole cube, I'll get 7 cube. So let's expand using the identity. The identity which with us is a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube, right? So let us use that. So it is nothing but x cube plus 3 times x square times 1 upon x plus 3 times x times 1 upon x whole squared plus 3 times, and the last term will be simply 1 upon x whole cube, and this is 7 cube. 7 cube is 343. Okay, so 7 cube is 343. Now what? So if you see, what we can do is, let us first club together what do we desire. So we want this. So x cube plus 1 by x cube is clubbed together. Now again, you can take some common terms here, isn't it? So if you see, this is nothing but 3 is common, x is common, and 1 by x is also common. And leftover is x here and here 1 by x. Correct? And this is equal to 343. Now this x and this x goes, and we already know x plus 1 by x value, that is 7. So hence x cube plus 1 upon x cube plus 3 into 7 is equal to 343. So hence x cube plus 1 upon x cube will be equal to 343 minus 21, which is equal to 322. So x cube plus 1 by x cube is 322.